So there's actually someone that uses Daemon tools by DJB, I guess. And so a way to basically understand the policy a bit, I guess, is to basically have a look at the policy. Let's open the Eclipse, my IDE. Now I already took a look at the Daemon tools policy, and there's one interface that stands out. And that's, let's look at ref policy and then submodules and then directory and then daemon tools. Somewhere there. Daemon tools, yeah, and then the interface file. So I think it's all about this one, daemon tools service domain. And basically what it says is daemon tools runs the domain that's defined. So it's basically the same idea as an init daemon domain. It basically inspects the domain and an entry point. So you get daemon tools and then your domain type and then your executable file type, your daemon executable file type. And then it basically calls the daemon tools IPC domain, which basically allows some IPC stuff, which basically it's just stupid. This is old stuff, which is basically stupid. You could basically change this to DOM trans pattern. I'll just then you could comment this out. So comment this out and this one out and just change this to DOM trans pattern, and then you wouldn't need the domain daemon tools IPC domain. Or actually you would, you do, because it's not actually now I see it. So okay, start of run starts it. So these permissions would be allowed on run, but it also needs these permissions on start, because start runs run and run runs the daemon, and that's basically why you need to interact with it. But anyways, point I'm trying to make is that if you develop a policy for a daemon tools service, then basically you probably need to call this one here. So do we have any policy that uses daemon tools? So I could try the following. Open up some shell. Yeah, here. RMRF my test in the meanwhile. And then cd get ref policy, and then just grab r, and then what was it, the daemon tools service domain. I'm stuck again. Yeah. I hope to fix that soon. So grab that and then point. So here are some stuffs that actually use daemon tools or actually support daemon tools. So you can basically choose. So let's just use DJB DNS, which is basically also. So if we look at this one here. And it's actually an interface file. So let's just look at that from the this one here. DJB DNS. Here it is. So it's in the interface file that call actually. So here's actually what it would look like. So make calls the daemon tool service domain here in an actual template. And it daemon tools read service. So let's have a look at daemon tool read service. It's somewhere. Here it is. And it's that's basically a PS process pattern. Not sure why var is there. But basically what it does, it reads the process state of the service, daemon tool service. So that's... And then it basically allows you to read the... So you could basically, if you... So this is what you basically need if you create a DJB DNS or DJB daemon tools domain.